Don't tell your mother. Kiss one another. Die for each other. We're cool for the summer.
So, this video, I'm actually responding to Jacqueline Glenn. But overall, what I'm actually doing is responding to a lot of the haters that she's gotten because of a recent video as well as other bullshit. I want to reiterate something because I got criticized for my personal views on this when I was responding a few weeks ago to a previous to a previous YouTube user who raised issues about something I will get to in a minute. And essentially I'm going to respond to those people too by basically responding to the issue that caused all this crap to begin with. But first let me talk about the video that was originally put up and what criticism that Miss Glenn got. I also want to reiterate the fact that I am not in any way, you know, one of these fanboys, a term that I fucking find just incredible that is used by internet tards anymore. You know, it's amazing the change in vernacular that we have and this obtuse sense of, you know, verbosity that exists within in the YouTube and, you know, any social media society. And I'm a fan, I guess. I'm more of an observer, really, I guess, because I wouldn't call myself a fan of Jacqueline Glenn, because there are some things I will admit that I disagree with her. It's much about how, you know, yeah, I can't really call myself a fan of her as I would saying, you know, of how I would say I'm a fan of Malice Rebel News. I would say that I'm more of a casual observer when it comes to Jacqueline Glenn. Not really a fan. Don't necessarily, you know, oppose a lot of her views. I do oppose some of her more liberal issue, because she is a liberal, so there's a few issues I actually disagree with. But to say that I'm an actual fan was probably overstretching it a bit. I'm more of a casual observer. Now, with that asininity out of the way, I'm basically going to respond on the issue of this video she did, in which she basically disagreed and criticized and rightfully opposed a video that was openly transphobic. Let me explain. This video basically was some woman that was a cis woman who was essentially grabbing at her lower extremities and essentially was, the video was her making fun of transgender individuals, and moreover the transgender community. And essentially this was a prank that she pulled that, you know, some individuals, you know, found funny. Alright? Fair enough. I'm not exactly going to get mad at you for finding it funny, though I disagree with what was said, and I myself did not find it funny, and I myself did find it insensitive. You know, I would say that there are some people that would be offended by it. I myself am not offended by it. I am not transgender. But there are people that that would offend. There are people that would find that insensitive, and there are some people that would find that just outrageous. That video that was made was just very distasteful, at least, you know, to say the very least. As a person myself who is very good friends with trans individuals, I myself would actually side with Jacqueline. I found it distasteful, I did not find it funny, and I find the people that actually are not only laughing along with it, well, maybe not laughing along with it, because again, I said that I'm not really, that if you find it funny, fine, that's your crude sense of humor. But it's more the people that defend this BS. It's the people that criticized Jacqueline for being overly PC and criticized her for, you know, being calling her a social justice warrior. Again, a thing that I also, a term I've fell victim to using, but a term I find that is overused as much as the word terrorist is, and frankly even fascist is, but it is a term nonetheless that was used basically to say that she was being a radical feminist and different things like that. And it's not that she's being a radical feminist. In fact, she's more of a gender equalist. And there is a big difference between the two. And if you want more information on that, I will gladly, you know, explain it to you in the comment section, if you, or, you know, or basically in any sort of inquiry into it, I will basically be glad to elaborate. But I'm not going into it in this video. There were people that called her a social justice warrior. I would not say that she's a social justice warrior, because while she is liberal, I would not say she was playing the card of being petty bourgeois. I would say in this case she is, you know, she is finding fault with something that is clearly and frankly, I will be the first to admit it, it's transphobic. It is clearly transphobic, and I think that is an accurate term. Excuse me. I think the fact, and to call her a social justice warrior is really over the top, because she's not really, you know, going, excuse me, she's not really going out on this high horse of trying to, this high horse of arrogance and anything like that, trying to, you know, drive home a point like this is my way or the highway situation. No, she's open for debate. It's just the whole idea is what this video entails, the content of that of the video she was responding to entails, was that it was clearly just insensitive. And frankly, transphobic. And the level of criticism that she got, and I responded to some of these people. I've not received a reply from any of them as of this recording, but I find that, you know, the people that got, you know, that started criticizing her and saying that she should basically focus more on her atheist beliefs and her, you know, some of the stuff that she normally does, I feel like these are people that not only are trying to marginalize her in not only the stuff that she's allowed to create, I think in some ways they're basically trying to force her hand, you know, and you know, basically that sort of thing where she should stick to this crap and the rest of this other shit, she should just basically stay quiet. a form of, you know, of I was trying to think of a term to basically say, but it's a form of censorship, really. It's a form of, because I was trying to think, and I don't think ad hominem censorship makes sense, nor is it completely accurate, but that's about as close to what I can think of at this moment. But yeah, I think essentially the people that are defending this bullshit and are literally, you know, criticizing her have just proven just how, you know, how transphobic they really are. I think they are also proving just where they actually stand on real issues. I mean, I also find it the great level of hypocrisy with a lot of people that, you know, claim to be this, these great, you know, bastions, these great activists and advocates of equality, especially towards, you know, especially in the form of identity politics. And yet, when it comes down to, like, when it comes down to gay rights issues, sure, people are all on board. But when it comes down to trans rights, you notice how certain individuals that were for that gay rights train suddenly for the trans people are just like, no, it's immoral, it's sick, it's blah, blah, blah. Or they hide it well, but it comes out in the form when they criticize someone for exposing clear and blatant transphobia. So I find it really hypocritical that people that claim to be equal rights supporters and equal rights opportunists and equal rights advocates and civil rights activists and all this sort of BS, I find it really hypocritical that they can be for gay rights, but as soon as it comes down, you know, or even pansexual rights and asexual rights and certain different things, but suddenly when we get to the issue of trans equality, suddenly people just don't either care, or they're openly critical of it. And I really just don't understand those people. Because, frankly, it's how I view, you know, people that are for the men's rights movement while claiming to be feminists or gender equalists and stuff like that. Well, no, that's a bad term. When they are men's rights activists but claim to be revolutionary. You know, it's just absolutely hypocritical. You know, it's like, if you're an equal rights activist, you're either equal rights or you're not. Equal rights means equal rights for not only racial equality, for gender equality. It also means, and it doesn't just also mean LGB equality or pans equality or, excuse me, asexual equality, or, you know, these different, you know, these different terms plus equality. It also means trans equality. And if you're not going to be part of the trans equality movement and be overly critical of trans individuals and the trans community, then you have no purpose being in the movement. You are not a revolutionary. You are not even a petty bourgeois liberal. You are a reactionary straight up. And I'm sorry to actually have to burst some fragile egos on that, but you are. If you're an equal rights supporter, it means you are an equal rights supporter. But if you are going to criticize and find fault with a certain group of individuals, and basically be reactionary towards them, then you are not an equal rights advocate. You are a pick-and-choose advocate. And I just find those people to be absolutely frigging it's obtuse. I find that the individuals that don't want to support these different that don't want to support, you know, these different forms of it, or all forms basically of equality, people that don't want to conform to all forms of equal rights advocacy, they rather just pick and choose. No, it's not a pick and choose game. I'd actually like to kind of throw this whole thing about how I'd really like to throw this thing in here, and I'm actually going to try to actually get the right quote, if I can. But, yeah, no, it's... Anyway, essentially the term was that revolution is not a dinner party. It's not just something you can casually go to and just walk out. No. Revolution, or even in some aspects, even, you know, some forms of liberalism, but let's just go right on to the issue. Equality itself is not a fucking dinner party. It's not just something you can go to, you know, basically, you know, fill your plate with the things that you like, and then just ignore the rest. It's not like that. Equality means that you are supportive, open, and you are willing to fight for the rights of everybody, of all people, not just the people that you want to advocate for. That is what this whole thing is about. If you are going to be, a LGBT rights supporter, then remember the T part. And that's the problem that I find with a lot of activists, you know, so-called activists and advocates and equal rights sort of people, is that they claim to be LGBT plus individual, you know, civil rights fighting individuals. But actually what they really are, just LGB advocates or LGBTQ advocates. They typically forget to the T part to that. And I find that there's been this grand divide between the LGB movement and the trans movement. That it seems like the LGB groups, you know, are getting more notoriety, they're getting more acceptance, and basically just rolling over the trans movement, overshadowing it. And to be honest, the trans movement, because of this, is being heavily marginalized, and the movement itself is really so stuck in the past by at least 20 to 30 years that, you know, a lot of, again, people find it to, you know, trans individuals to be, you know, it's one of those things that really hurts me, because as a person that normally supports trans rights and has been a huge advocate, as well as having, you know, many friends part of that community, it really hurts me that these people don't that a lot of people don't pay any attention, or simply don't care, or even claim, or even worse, go out and insult these people and make fun of these people, when, frankly, these individuals are just trying to live their lives and just want to be, you know, to be the person that they truly feel. That's it. Is that so hard to understand? You know, and yet then you've got those activists that claim to be LGBT, but they forget the T part and put, you know, and are not LGBT, they're LGBQ at most. And there needs to be this emphasis on actually supporting the trans rights movement and supporting trans rights and trans individuals. So, but to the people that are criticizing Miss Glenn and criticize, you know, all this sort of crap because of what she said, then I'm sorry, but you just showed your true colors. You showed your transphobia. You showed your reactionism. And frankly, you went full right wing. Some of you went full right wing. And as so-called liberal rights activists, you know you should never go full right wing. So, yeah. The other criticism that I wanted to make, because I'm not really going to focus really on the patriarchy thing, because I've already done a couple videos about gender equality and stuff like that, but I am going to talk about my opinion on the plagiarism issue that has been brought up. And again, I've had an argument with somebody over this, but I'm sorry, but I really don't believe in any idea of plagiarism on YouTube. I believe that plagiarism is something that occurs. Don't get me wrong, I admit that plagiarism occurs in the social media realm. Twitter is a perfectly good example. And frankly, we got people ripping off other people's shit all the time, but it's Tumblr and people don't care. And, you know, I mean, if we really want to dive into to what is plagiarism in social media, you know, then technically retweeting somebody's, you know, bullshit could be considered plagiarism, or taking a quote from somebody, you know, and not get, you know, basically repeating what your friend fucking said on Facebook or something could be considered fucking plagiarism, you know. And the fact that people are so concerned that she plagiarized theoretical bullshit and whatever the other asshole, you know, asshole's name that was out there that, you know, people were bitching about, saying, you know, especially on the Drunken Peasants podcast, which, and with all due respect to the DPP, I occasionally tune into that. I occasionally, you know, I have things I agree and things I disagree with. But with all due respect, I think when it came down to the issue of Jacqueline Glenn and plagiarism, I think it's complete horseshit. And I think it's just all that all these people that are claiming plagiarism, it's like there's things that are said. A lot of people have, you know, YouTube is this community where people post whatever the fuck they want, because free speech in America. But, or wherever the fuck you're also from. Let's not think out just in terms, let's not be American-centric and first worldist. But, you know, but yes, free speech, people can post what they fucking want. And for certain people, like theoretical bullshit, like Jacqueline Glenn, and even to a more, you know, more far leftist extreme myself, people typically tend to have similar viewpoints. And, you know, sometimes people will say similar things. And then there's times where people might say the same thing from something that they watched. I myself have probably been guilty of that myself. But do I consider that plagiarism? No. because I don't believe that there's an actual idea of plagiarism going on in YouTube. I don't believe in plagiarism on YouTube. You know, I believe that if you rip off someone's work and stuff like that, you know, word for word, verbatim, and you're making money off of that, if you're, you know, basically, yeah, if you're basically exploiting somebody's work for money, then yeah, I think there is a, then you might have some valid claims to it. But considering how much that YouTube already basically rips us off anyway, I really just don't fucking, you know, I really don't even see what the point of bitching about plagiarism has to do when the real problem itself is YouTube. You know, anybody, you know, you can call a straw man on that if you want to, but whatever. The point that I'm trying to make is that I don't believe in plagiarism in a social media aspect, at least concerning YouTube. I don't believe that what Jacqueline Gwynn, I think that she ought, that she probably should be more careful. She definitely should cite her sources. I myself try to cite my sources, or at least claim where I got the information. For instance, Reuters, Mouse Rebel News, aka Jason Unruh, or Scottish Socialist, or John Doe, or, you know, whoever the fuck it was. You know, I typically try to do that. But, you know, everybody has similar views, and sometimes things will come out sounding the same. It's just a matter of life. It's a matter of YouTube. It's a matter of social fucking media. So, to all these people bitching about how she plagiarized and stuff like that, get off of it. Fucking get off, down off the cross, use the wood to build a bridge, and get the fuck over it. I'm tired of it. I'm tired of this plagiaristic PC BS being thrown around, you know, by these, what I would call social justice warrior idiots, you know, and I'm just done. I'm done with it, you know. So, yeah, go ahead and fucking criticize me for it. Blow me. I'm NorCal Nick, leader of the revolutionist movement, and this has been NorCal Corner. Peace.